Hello friends, welcome to my channel. In this video, I am going to explain you PLC ladder diagram using timer for double acting cylinders. So friends, let's start. Friends, first we will draw the schematic diagram for this pneumatic process. Then we will draw PLC ladder diagram using that pneumatic diagram. So friends, here this is a problem statement. Here A plus delay, B plus A minus, B minus and delay. One delay is for 10 second and second delay is for 60 second. Here there are two delays, so we require two timers in the PLC ladder diagram. Now friends, let's see the schematic diagram for this particular process. While drawing here, let's first draw the cylinders. This is cylinder A, cylinder A, this is cylinder B, this is cylinder B. Here friends, this is a 4x2 wall, this one is also 4x2 wall. This is 4x2 wall and it is, we consider it as a solenoid operated. So these are two solenoids in each case. This is Y1, this is Y2, this is Y3, this is Y4. Here friends, and remember friends, when it is in forward direction, that is in the rightward direction, then it is plus, positive. And when it is leftward direction, or you can say in the retracted position, then it is A minus or B minus. In case of B, it is B minus. In case of A cylinder, it is A minus. Here friends, now we will give some nomenclatures. First, here this is this position of the cylinder means forward position. So here it is A plus, and this position also, here this one, it is a forward position in the rightward direction, so it is B plus. Here friends, at this position there is a limit switch which we will include it here, and it is, we give it as a name S2 here. And for this limit switch which will be at this position, we give S4. Now friends, this is a retracted position which is shown on this cylinder as a dotted line, and this is the end of this, you can say, this is a retracted position of this A cylinder. So this one, this position is A minus, and limit switch which will be here is S1. And here in case of B cylinder, this is the retracted position, that is on the leftward side, which will be negative. So here B minus, this retracted position, and the limit switch which will be here is given, we will give the name for it as S3. Here Y1 is for forward position of the piston, so it is for A plus, and this is for retracted position, that is it is for A minus, Similarly, here this for y3 is for b plus and y4 is for b minus here. Now friends, see the sequence. This is the sequence, but while drawing the schematic diagram, we will consider the sequence of cylinders operations from right hand side to the left hand side. So here we will first draw the, we will show the first B minus connections. So here friends, this is the second position, that is this one retracted position. So here this is this arrow will be go here, the air will go here, and the air from this side of the piston will come out and goes here. This air goes to the atmosphere, so it is exhausted. This is triangle symbol for this, and this is round symbol for reservoir, for accumulator or any gas source, pneumatic source. So this air goes from here. Similarly, for now for A minus, this arrow will go here, and from here air will come out and goes to the atmosphere exhausted, and this is source of gas or air. Normally we show only one actuated position of the cylinders, but for our understanding in this problem, we will draw B plus and A plus also for our understanding purpose only. So here it is in the red line. This is forward for A plus, and this one, and this is exhaust again. This is for our forward connection, forward direction, that is rightward direction, A plus. Here also for B plus will include here, and another one is here. This is exhaust. Okay, done. This is for B minus, forward position. This is exhaust air. Now friends, let's draw the ladder diagram for this particular example or question. So friends, here first we will draw two power rails. These are two power rails which we draw in the every PLC ladder diagram. Here friends, this is positive, this is negative. Here friends, first we will draw the, these are two power rails, this one, and this is also called as power rail. Now friends, here see A plus. Sorry friends, first we will draw the first rung which is common in every PLC ladder diagram. So here friends, this is start push button. This is push button 1. This is start push button, and here then this is a stop push button 2, and then here control relay CR, and here we provide it latching. This is CR again. Here friends, this is start and this one is for stop. Now next rung is, these in the middle of these two power rails, with the lines which we will draw are called as rungs. Here friends, now second rung is this one. This is again CR. Then this one is DN2, that is done 2 here in this case, and this is counter, symbol for counter. About this rung, second rung, I will tell at the end because it is related to the end, second last rung. So now here friends, this is also CR. In every rung we need to use this CR in every rung, further rungs. Now here friends, first is A plus. Here friends, as we can see, A plus, when we press the Y1, then only the forward A plus condition, that is forward flow of air, will go, and the rod of the piston will then go forward direction, that is on the right hand side direction. And when it reaches to the S2 limit switch, then it stops here friends. So on the third rung, here on this rung, this is CR, and then this is Y1. We close the contacts and start the connection. So this is Y1 here, this is in closed condition, and limit switches are in normally closed condition. As here limit switch is S2, so it is S2 here, and it is related to forward condition, that is A plus. This means this meaning of this rung is the forward motion of the this A cylinder has been started, that is A plus condition has been started. Then we need to show the stop position, that is when S2 contacts get open, and this process, forward process, has been completed. So here friends, again this is CR, and then this is S2, the contacts open, and this process has been completed, and timer here after completing this process, forward process, that is A plus, the timer will come into action. So here we will show the timer. There are three positions in the timer. One is preset, accumulator, and third one is time based. Here say friends, see here, the preset value is 10 seconds. So here 10 second is our preset value. In this, we have setted this preset value in the timer as 10 second. This is T on 1, friends. Okay, T on 1. Here friends, now this is enable, and this is done. Okay, this is enabled. Now it is timer has been enabled. Here friends, timer has been enabled. When preset value is, our preset value is 10 here, 10 seconds. When this S2, that A plus A plus process is completed, and it limit switch contacts gets open, and this process stops, then countdown starts, 1, 2, 3, 4, like that. And when it reaches, and it this countdown has been recorded, or you can say accumulated in this accumulator, and when this accumulator reaches the 10 second, then the done comes into timer, done comes into operation, and this further process starts. So here it is enable, timer enable here. When this S2 A plus process completed, then timer enables, and when accumulator accumulates 10 seconds as is equal to preset value, then timer enable, timer done, and that means timer process has been completed and the B plus process has been started here in this case. And see here friends, time base is used is the timing update interval for this timer. Now friends, we will see the B plus timer is done now. So here next rung is for B plus. Here friends, this is CR again, and as timer is done, so timer is done, so this is DN1 in open condition, DN1. And now for here B plus, we will press the we will use this Y3 solenoid, and similar as per A plus, this process is also starts, and up to here S4 limit switch. So here friends, now again this is Y3 normally closed, and again here this is S4 in closed condition. S4 is in closed condition in this process, and this is now B plus, means now B plus process has been started, operation has been started. So we need to stop this B plus operation. It will stop when and then and only then it reaches the S4 limit switch. So we need to show the in the ladder diagram, we open the contact of the limit switch. So here CR, now contacts get open. So S4, it reaches the cylinder, has been piston rod has been reached to the S4, and contacts open, and then further process has been started, will start, that is A minus here. So here friends, we will S4. Now here friends, S4 for this A, this process has been completed. So now here A minus we have to operate. So here for A minus, we press the there is actuation from the Y2 solenoid. So and the connection, as we can see here, the air will go to here, goes at this position of the piston, and the piston moves from this one, this position, to this position, that is in the reverse, in the retracted position, that is in the leftward direction. And here also friend, when the piston rod reaches S1 limit switch, then its contacts open and this process is completed. So here we use Y2 in closed condition, here Y2, and this is now S1 is in closed condition. So here S1 in closed condition here, and it is A minus done. This is completed, and the meaning of this rung is A minus process has been started, that is piston is moving from rightward direction, right hand side, to the left hand side, that is in the retracted position. Now we need to stop this, for when it reaches to the S1, it stops. So its S1 contacts should be open. So here now CR again, and then here this is S1 in open contact. Now here this process is completed here, A minus process. Then next process is B minus. For this here, for this we will operate Y4 solenoid, and here also the air goes from this line, and piston move from right hand side to the left hand side in the retracted position, and the when this piston rod reaches the S3, its contact gets open and it stops here, and for then further process is started. So here now Y4, you operate Y4, here Y4, and limit switch is S3. So here it is S3 and it is for B minus. Now it's this process is B minus process, operation has been started. So when it reaches to the S3, then it's a process, this process is completed. So we will show here CR, S3 process has been completed. So S3 here in open contact. Now next is here delay. As you can see, it is 60 second delay. So as per previous timer here, the second, this timer, this is preset accumulator, this is time base. Here preset value is 60 second. This is T on 2 second timer, and here again enable, done. Here also friends, when the accumulator accumulates 60 seconds, then timer done, timer completes. When this process is completed, that is B minus operation completed, then timer ons. So timer enable here, and then and when 60 second completed, then timer is done, timer completed. This is the last process of this PLC ladder diagram, and here the last rung is the end rung. This is common for the every PLC ladder diagram. This first rung and this last rung is common in every PLC ladder diagram except for multi cycle operation. Okay, now about this rung, second rung. Here friends, as this second timer is not in operation, so at the first rung we will use DN2 in closed row condition here for last second timer. So friends, we have seen PLC ladder diagram using timer for double acting cylinders. Thank you friends for watching this video. Like, share and comment for this video, and subscribe my channel. Thank you.